specifications. And we have for this wall here. So we're gonna follow the guidelines exactly. Which in this case happens to be, and here it is, here's a detail we got from the city. There's three options on here. It's A, B, and C. They're all basically the same size footing. And the only difference is they're turned in a different direction. Like one footing is designed if you have a lot of space, so you can go out on your width. One footing is designed is real deep, but very narrow. Another footing is designed is if you have trouble with the moving, put it on one side. So those are the three options. I'm going with the basic option here, which is for 6 foot long, 36 inches wide, and it's 1 foot deep, and all of the color footing is a minimum of 10 inches below grade. So this is how I do it. And there's a lot of ways you can paint your rebar, but this is a simple way. It stays really cool. And the color doesn't move. So I'm gonna hang this 2x4 level. The elevation doesn't matter where you put it. I just chose this spot here at this height. Basically, I just want it level, and I want it right in the middle of the wall so I can hang my vertical steel from this 2x4. Now, since I have the 2x4 level and it's in the middle of the wall, I can also measure down from this 2x4 to any height I want, and it's always going to be level. And this particular design here has 3 and 4 rebars running horizontally in the footing, and spacing in the middle and the footing of the edges running horizontal. And every 24 inches is the spacing for the vertical, and it's all number 4. So what I do is I like to get a piece of vertical right in the end of each block, the end of each block. That's probably what's gonna feel what happens. We'd start from the end, like on a carpet or getting the fans from it. It's gonna be most likely on the end of the block. So I always like steel on the end, so I started with that. And then I just went every 24 inches. When you do a layout, you know that a block is 16 inches wide in this case. So you could go over 4 inches and you're going to first sail on your first block. You're going to go. Now if you went 8 inches over, then that would be good because you'd be right in the center of the block and you'd be hitting a limb. So you can go 4 or 12, and that's about it. And then you continue from there to the original block hole. the height, and I know that this wood's level. My block wall's gonna be level, so I just have to decide on how high I want this floor. Then I'm matching another wall, and I want the grout line to match it with another wall, so it's not really determined elevation that I just need to match. So, basically, I ended up running out of concrete. I was probably about 2 years or so, because I used the same load to cut the back panel of the frame. We got the whole back panel of the frame out, and that seems to be good enough. And then I just kind of erasing this footing and put the rest of the concrete in this frame. And it took my time to get away and fall into the truck and these lines from my head. So, I was probably going to be a short run and just kind of a few bags of that. Is some blue hot concrete mix, 2500 PSI. And I think the water and just putting it in there and that. So I don't know how to do it, I just dump my dry bags in there, just mix it in the bag. So we made it pretty hard. It's only 3 hours. I don't think we got 6 bags in here that we need to get my phone right. Going down to the street. And now, if I would have stayed at the